Hello and welcome back to another tutorial video. Today we are in Steam and I'm going to be showing you how to set up and use any controller on Steam. Now, as long as the game obviously supports it, and even if it doesn't, there are some things you can do to kind of tweak some things and maybe still use a controller. So the first thing you have to understand is in order to connect a controller to your PC, you either have to do it via Bluetooth. So you go to your Bluetooth settings here, as you see I've done here, go to Bluetooth, go to add Bluetooth or other device, and then do whatever it requires to put that specific controller in discovery mode. So for me, I have the new Xbox Series X controller here, and I have to hold down the little Bluetooth button on the top of the controller and the Xbox home button, and it begins to blink. And then once it does, you can see here at the very bottom, my Xbox wireless controller is connected. Or the easy way, the way I prefer, is just to plug it in via USB to your PC. Again, depending on your setup, that may not be the easiest way. So once your controller is indeed connected, you need to go back and navigate back over to Steam, make sure you're logged in, and then there's a couple of ways to navigate to the controller settings. Most people will tell you to go into big picture mode. And the easiest way of doing that is clicking the two arrows here that says big picture mode in the upper right hand corner. That will then take you directly to big picture mode here in Steam, to where you can go to settings. And then once under settings, you can then go to controller settings. And then you can see here any controller that you have connected will show up here under detected controllers. Couple of things here. We have our guide button focuses Steam. Leave that checked there. And then we have PlayStation and Xbox configuration support. These are the two most commonly used controllers, obviously, or you can use a Switch Pro controller as well. If we go here and check the Xbox configuration support, what I prefer doing is go under here where you see detected controllers and then select the one that you have connected. And then the one that you're going to want to do is go to define layout. And then we'll go over a couple of these other options as well, but go ahead and select define layout. Now, this is going to be the generic layout for the controller. So as you can see here, primary action will be the A button, going back will be the B button, the tertiary action will be the Y button, secondary will be X, like reload, things like that. Now, all of this is great, right? All of this is fantastic. This is going to be the general settings for that controller. But if we go back, what I like to do is I actually like to select a game. So I'll go to my library. You still have to be in big picture mode. And let's go ahead and select Streets of Rage 4. Now, if you hover over a game, you can see here that if there is a controller little icon here, that means that that game has support for a controller, okay? So any game that does not have a controller, it only has a keyboard, that game is only going to be keyboard and mouse. Now, there are little workarounds, but I'm not going to cover that in this video. Now, before we do any of this, I want to make sure that I let you guys know that you need to go up to Steam and then go to Settings. And then under Steam Settings here, go to Controller before you do anything. And then once here, you need to go ahead and go to General Controller Settings. And then right here where we just talked about, like the Xbox configuration support, if you have an Xbox controller connected, which I do, you want this to be checked in order for you to be able to go in and fine tune per game. So if this is unchecked, and you try to go to the individual games and change the settings around, it will not allow you to do that. So go ahead and make sure that's checked. And the same thing goes for PlayStation, Switch controller, or just a generic gamepad, right? Okay, so make sure that's checked and let's hop back over to big picture mode. So once we're here under manage game and then go to controller configuration. So go to controller configuration. This is going to adjust the configuration for the controller for this specific game. So whatever game you've selected, you've opened in your library and you've gone over to, this is only going to be that specific game. Okay. So you can see here that we have different, you know, things that we can change. So we can go here to our buttons selection here, and then we can go and we can make the B button if we wanted to be a specific key, right? So we want the B button to be the R key or the pickup item, whatever it may be, right? You can see your controller over here and then all of your different things that you can add here on your keyboard. So the B button, the binding for the B button will be the R key, right? So if you would normally hit R in a game, that's going to be your B button on a controller. This is great for games that are necessarily made for controller, but they still have access or the ability to use a controller. Now I'm gonna go ahead and reset this back to default by using my controller here. I'm gonna tap the X button to reset that back to default there. So I'm gonna go ahead and get get out of this selection here. And then as you can see, something else that you can do is you can actually go here and you can browse configurations. So as you can see here, there's different configurations within Steam. There's the recommended configuration for this game. There's the one that you've saved personally, the one that we were just on, and then community or templates. So if we go to community here, we can see that this one here has the most upvotes. It's got 19 votes there. Recent playtime's got like over 2,000 hours of playtime. If we select that binding, it'll allow us to preview the actual binding. So as you can see here, we have the joystick move, we have the D-pad, what it does there, and then we have the Y and the X button here. Now, if you want to do this, you just go ahead and go to apply configuration, and then as you can see, the key bindings for this configuration is now what I'm going to be using for this game. Okay, so that's all under controller configuration. This can be done for each individual game. Now, under controller options here, we can see that Steam input per game settings requires game relaunch. Now, global setting Xbox here, this is going to be the global settings for your controller if you have one set. And then rumble setting, the controller preference is on, but you can turn this to be on or off if that's something that you want to do. So again, all of this is in each individual game. Again, so if I go into another game, go to manage game, go to controller configuration, you can see here that this is what the controller configurations are now. And I can even browse configurations down here to the community, and you can see if there's any templates here. You can see there's one for a gamepad, and then there's one for a keyboard, WASD and mouse. That's going to be kind of the generic keyboard and the generic gamepad or controller types right here under templates. Now, some games aren't going to have templates, others are. It just depends on the popularity of the game and the, I guess you'd say, widespread usage of a controller. So again, all of this is done in big picture mode, so make sure that you are in big picture mode. To get out of big picture mode, it's fairly simple. You just go back, go to the power button here, and then go to exit big picture. That will then take you back to the general Steam user interface. But if you have any questions about how to set up and use a controller, please put those in the comment section down below. Thank you guys, as always, for watching my content, and I will see you guys in the next video.